completely enclosed module. It takes 12 volts in. The output, it's not a set of volt-free contacts, it is actually 12 volt comes straight back out. And if you've got a higher load, I mean, this supposedly says you can switch 10 amps with it, but I never trust those little relays. I'm guessing it's going to be a Songo relay inside. It usually is a Songo relay. It's one of the most common brands in China, although you just never know what's going to be a copy and what's not. I should mention the display here looks a bit uneven on the camera, but to me it looks pretty even. They're obviously sort of cutting back in the circuitry for the multiplex and just use a minimum number of resistors, but it achieves the function that's required. But the volt-free contact here, well, in this case it's not a volt-free contact, the 12 volt output through the relay could then be used either to drive a load directly or if you wanted to switch a heating load or something, you could then drive a relay or even a solid state relay with it. The module just has two buttons and you can use it for heating or cooling, and it's very simple. If you press the left hand button, that's the start temperature. In this case its default as it comes is 25 degrees Celsius. If you press the right button, that's the end button, end temperature, and it's 40 degrees Celsius is the factory default. So let's set an example here. Say for instance I wanted to use this to cool. So the temperature I'd want it for on, you press it, you press and hold until it starts flashing, and then you can use the up down arrows. So I'm going to reduce that to 22. If you hold it, it fast forwards, oh, a bit too much. And that's the start temperature, 22, and I want it to go off if it's cooling at about 20. So I press the right hand button, the off button, until it starts flashing, and then I can then use the down button to actually take it right down to about 20. Clicky, clicky, clicky. And after a while, it stops blinking, goes back to the temperature, and it does store that in non-volatile memory. Let me demonstrate. I'm going to turn the power off. It's gone off. Turn it back on. And once it's initialized, it's going to turn on at 22 degrees centigrade and off at 20. So at the moment, it's too cold for it to turn on the cooling, so I'm going to heat it up with my hand. And as soon as it gets up to 22, you'll see the little light come on, and this light will come on too, because I put a light on it to actually show that. So there we go. It's up above 22, so effectively it's turned on the cooling. This could be running a fan, or it could be running a refrigeration unit, or just operating a solenoid valve to actually allow refrigeration plant to operate. And as the temperature comes back down, obviously it's going to turn off when it reaches the target of 20 again. And the fact you can set the on and off temperature independently means that you can set a hysteresis. In this case, I set a hysteresis of 2 degrees. So now, supposing you wanted to make it set it to heat instead of cool, all you'd do is you'd select that one, and say you wanted to come on at 20, and then you wanted it to go off, or wait till it stops flashing, at 22. Oop. Put it into blinky mode. Okay. So now it's cold, so it wants heat. So now I'm going to apply the heat, and as soon as it gets above 22, it cuts out. And likewise, when it cools down, which I should cool it down with this frosty beverage, when it gets down to about 20, it will cut back in again. Very simple to operate. Very simple indeed. If you wanted to restore it to its factory default setting values, to be honest, I don't think that's about all the parameters I can find that you can set. But if you press and hold both buttons simultaneously until it goes 888, it does the display test, and then it defaults to 25 on and 40 off. So that would be for heating, and it would heat up to 40 degrees Celsius.